to thee, O God, glory to thee, O heavenly King, O Comfort, the Spirit of Truth, Wart in all places and fearless all things, Treasury of good things and Giver of life, come into wellness and cleanse us from every stain and save our souls, O good one. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Lord, cleanse us from our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities. O Holy God, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and unto the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in the heavens, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, both now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Christ is risen, brethren. Today is May 18th, 2020. I am reading from the Prologue of Ohrid, Volume 1. Today we'll be reading the stories of saints, the holy martyr Theodotus of Ancyra, and the seven maiden martyrs, Tecusa, Alexandra, Claudia, Philina, Euphrasia, Matrona, and Julia. The holy martyrs Peter, Dionysius, Andrew, Paul, and Christina. And the holy martyrs Heraclius, Paulinus, and Benedimus of Athens. The holy martyr Theodotus of Ancyra, and the seven maiden martyrs, Tecusa, Alexandra, Claudia, Philina, Euphrasia, Matrona, and Julia. Theodotus was an innkeeper in Ancyra during the reign of Diocletian. Although married, he lived according to the word of the apostle. They that have wives, be as though they had none. 1 Corinthians 7, verse 29. He maintained the inn in order to help Christians without attracting suspicion. His inn was a shelter for the persecuted faithful. Theodotus secretly sent help to those Christians who fled to the mountains, and he secretly gathered the bodies of those who died and buried them. At that time, seven maidens were brought to trial, tortured for Christ, ridiculed, and finally drowned in a lake. One of them, Saint Tecusa, appeared in a dream to Theodotus and told him to remove their bodies from the lake and bury them. In the dark of night, Theodotus went out with a companion to fulfill the wish of the martyr. Led by an angel of God, he succeeded in locating all seven bodies and burying them. But his companion betrayed Theodotus to the judge, and the judge subjected him to cruel tortures. Theodotus endured all the sufferings as though he were in someone else's body. Keeping his whole mind immersed in the Lord, after the tortures had transformed Theodotus's body into wounds and knocked out his teeth with a stone, he ordered that the martyr be beheaded. When he was led to the scaffold, many Christians wept for him. But Saint Theodotus said to them, "Brethren, do not weep for me, but glorify our Lord Jesus Christ, who helped me to finish my course and overcome mine enemy." Having said this, he placed his head on a block under the sword and was beheaded in the year 303 AD. A priest honorably buried this martyr's body on a hill outside the town. Later, a church dedicated to Saint Theodotus was built on this spot. The holy martyrs Peter, Dionysius, Andrew, Paul, and Christina. Peter, a handsome young man, Dionysius, a distinguished man, Andrew and Paul, soldiers, and Christina, a 16-year-old virgin. They all courageously confessed Christ the Lord and endured sufferings and death for his name. Nicomachus, who was tortured with them, denied Christ in the midst of his tortures and instantly lost his mind as a madman. He bit his body and vomited foam from the mouth until he died. This occurred in the year 250 AD. The holy martyrs Heraclius, Paulinus, and Benedimus of Athens. All three were Athenians. They suffered for the faith during the reign of Decius. They were burned in a fiery furnace for the name of Christ.
And also today,
these saints are commemorated. Martyr Euphrasia of Nicaea in 303 AD, Martyr Simeon, Isaac, and Bastisos of Persia, 339 AD, Hieromartyr Potamon, Bishop of Heraclea, 341 AD, Martyrs David and Tarekan of Georgia, 693 AD, St. Macarius Glucharov, Archimandrite of the Altai, 1847 AD, St. John Gashkevich, Archpriest of Korma, 1917 AD, New Hieromartyr Damian Strabak, Junior Priest of Grachovo, Serbia, 1940s, Greek calendar, St. Stephen the New, Patriarch of Constantinople, 893 AD, St. Anastasios, St. Martinian, Monk of the Erovinthus Quarter, Constantinople.
Hymn of Praise, St. Theodotus. Near Ankara, on a green hill, a group of persecuted Christians, with a blessing ate their meal. What the sun is among the shining stars, so was Theodotus among this group. And next to him sat the presbyter Fronto. To Fronto Theodotus said, "This spot is suitable for a church over the relics of honorable martyrs." Fronto replied to Theodotus, "Endeavor, most wonderful man, to obtain relics of the martyrs for us, and we will easily build a church with which to adorn this place." Theodotus the All-Wonderful smiled. From his right hand he removed the ring, gave it to the honorable Fronto, and spoke to him these words, "I give you my word of honor and the ring as a pledge. I will soon procure relics and place them on this spot." Theodotus said, "This is a prophecy." He was prophesying his own suffering and his martyrdom for Christ. As he said, so it happened. His relics were placed on that spot, and over them a church was built as a wonderful memorial of an immortal victory near Ankara on a green hill.
Reflection. To conceal one's virtues and ascetic labors has been the custom of ascetics, both female and male, not only in the earliest times of Christianity, but throughout all ages to the present time. Eudoxia, wife of the glorious Prince Dmitry Donskoy, the liberator of Russia from the Tartars, was left a widow in 1389, while still fairly young. Imbued with devotion, this princess built many churches, distributed alms, and secretly weakened her body by fasting and long vigils. She wore an iron chain around her body. Meanwhile, she always appeared happy before the public, clothed in opulence and adorned with pearls. The public said many things about her, and they began to spread rumors that she was leading an immoral life. Her sons also heard about this, and insulted and embittered openly, informed their mother of what was being said about her. Their mother opened her luxurious robe, and her sons, with great horror, saw her body completely withered, dried up, and bound with iron chains.
Contemplation. Contemplate the action of God the Holy Spirit upon the martyrs, how the Holy Spirit provided them with comfort in their sufferings, how occasionally, according to his will, he made their bodies immune to the effects of fire.
Homily. On the testimony of the Spirit of God, the Spirit of truth who proceeded from the Father, he shall testify of me. John 15, verse 26. God the Son sent God the Holy Spirit into the world to testify of him until the end of time. He shall testify of me. How will God the Spirit testify of God the Son? God the Spirit will testify in many ways. By attracting men's souls to Christ's church, by revealing to them the meaning of the Holy Scriptures, by leading their minds to the commandments of Christ, by giving warmth, freshness, power, and gentleness to the words of Christ, by converting repentant sinners to righteousness, by fulfilling all the promises and prophecies of Christ to men, to nations, and to God's church, by strengthening the church of Christ and holding it firm against all the tempests of time and all the evils of Hades and men throughout the ages. The Spirit who works in these and many other similar ways is the Spirit of God. The Spirit of truth, gracious, life-creating, and all-powerful. Not one of Christ's words goes against the Spirit of God, nor does the Spirit of God go against a single word of Christ. That is why, when the Spirit of God is pleased to enter into the heart of man, such a man is enlivened and becomes a true witness to all that Christ said and did. Then that man believes joyfully and unwaveringly. For how could he not believe the greatest and the most enduring eyewitness of a participator in all the words, miracles, and works of Christ? Thus, brethren, let us pray before all and above all that this eyewitness and participator, the Holy and All-Powerful Spirit, will settle in our hearts so that our faith may become alive, unwavering, and joyous. O God, the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of truth, come and abide in us. To Thee be glory and praise forever. Amen.
This video was created by John
and Catherine.
Thank you and God bless.